everybody, and welcome to Hometown Cable, a program called What's Going On Here. I'm Bob Venn, and we're visiting in Plattsburgh. We're at Cumberland Head at the Crate Center. Let me tell you, it's happening here. Balloons flying all over, people all dressed up with nice necklaces and flowers. What is this all about, Kathleen Hazel?
Well, May is Older Americans Month, and we decided this year we'd have a countywide celebration. So we started fundraising in December, selling calendars, that lottery calendars, and we came up with a great committee, and we put together a fine day for all of our seniors.
I see a senior walking by there. Father McCaslin,
he's a very famous senior citizen, and he's going to do our invocation for us today.
Okay, Father McCaslin, of course, been in Champlain. He was at Moore's Forks until a little over a year ago, and now he's in Cherubusco.
Yes.
Semi-retired. Okay,
right.
Well, how many people are you expecting?
We're expecting over 600 people for lunch today, and
are
probably about
serious?
400 for dinner, yes. And we have the big band sound coming from Messina, New York tonight, and they will be doing all the old songs from the 40s. The Glenn Miller type songs, and we are hoping that we'll have a great crowd that will stay for the dance tonight. We have all kinds of business expos here today, all the nonprofit agencies that deal with our seniors in the county, and we have all kinds of center stage entertainment that will go on throughout the day. We have a wonderful seminar booth and lots of good food to eat.
There's a lot of these people are going to get tired before this is all over.
Well, they'll have to go home and have a nap, maybe.
I was going to say, it starts at 10 here,
right.
And we're here on the, today's the 6th.
Right.
Of May, between my wife's birthday and Mother's Day, right between them, and it's going to go on until 10:30 tonight?
Yes.
That's a big undertaking.
That's a long day, yes.
Now, when are you leaving to take your nap so we can make sure that we can...
I'm going to wait until around 1 o'clock this morning.
You are, huh?
Right.
How long have you been planning for this, Kathleen?
We have been planning since last June.
Terrific.
Yes.
Terrific. So this is the summer program instead of like the one at Altona you had?
Oh, no, we'll
year.
Still have our old-fashioned day picnic.
This is an extra.
This is for our Older Americans Month in May. We're honoring all the seniors for the
Americans Month. I've seen some of the vehicles from some of the nursing homes in the
yes,
area.
Yes, we have Meadowbrook Nursing Home here, Cedar Hedge, and let's see, there's another one here. Sacred Heart Nursing Home is here also.
Oh, that's
so
terrific.
We're really pleased about that.
Really, I bet
lots
you are.
Lots of families have brought in their 90-year-olds too,
okay.
So that's really wonderful.
Tell us your position. You're executive director of the Senior Citizens Council. What does
Council.
That mean?
Tell okay. us. Okay, we are funded by the Office for Aging, and we have five big programs that we do for seniors throughout the county. We have the Senior Center at 159 Margaret Street. We have health, education, and recreation programs there. We also edit and produce the Senior Sentinel that comes out once a month in your Plattsburgh Press Republican. We also have the Title V employment training program for seniors. The nutrition program for the elderly, the Meals on Wheels, and the congregate programs as well, and we have a small transportation program.
Are you reading this someplace? You
no.
rattled that off like you knew I was going to ask you that
no,
question.
No, but I have to remember all those
you
facts.
Said you must order in a certain way, too. And there's a lady right behind us who we're seeing here, Loretta.
Yes.
Now, she's no senior citizen.
No.
What's that lady doing here?
But she knows that all these events are so wonderful, she has to come and see what's
she's
going
come,
on.
Come over here, Sue Light. Come over and talk.
Thank you very much. You,
okay, well, okay, we'll talk to you later,
care.
Right? Okay.
Bye-bye. You're probably really busy right now.
Sue Light, well, what are you doing here?
I came to see you, Bob.
You came to see me? Well, what you came to see one of the senior citizens.
Absolutely.
All right. Well, Sue, give us your title with the city.
Promotions and Special Events Coordinator.
And guess where most of it is that you're coordinating?
Right
in
here.
This building. You've been there a couple of years doing this?
3 years.
Three? How
Three
time,
whole years. Time,
time
flies when you're having
they
fun.
They said they were going to keep you as long as you're making money for the city. You must be making money for the city.
Yeah.
You're filling up. You had how'd your play come out good that they had here?
Oh, Phantom was wonderful.
You got more coming wonderful. Up? You got more events?
Yes, we do. Yes,
okay,
we
now
do.
If someone wanted to know what's coming up the rest of the year at Crete, how can they find out?
Call 563-CITY, C-I-T-Y.
Everybody does this now. Okay, 563-CITY.
Yes.
And you can tell them what's coming up because you've got an assorted for all types of people that can enjoy something?
I have one master list of all the events that are already booked,
mm-hmm.
and I will mail it to anyone. They can call. That's an answering machine. And if they leave their name and address on the answering machine, we will mail them a list.
Okay.
That's also the number to call for information about the Independence Day Parade, the Mayor's Cup, and the Riverwalk.
Where do you call if you want to talk to a real live person?
Well, the line that I have is unlisted, and it's used for booking events only.
Oh,
because
all right.
It's only one telephone line, so we use the other line for information, And my line is used for actually booking the events and talking to the promoters.
Okay. Your line, I've heard your line before, so don't tell me about
you. I have a great line.
I could talk like this to Sue a little bit because her husband is my nephew, of course, to make sure my niece, I guess.
We're stuck with each other.
All right. And what great one to be stuck with that beautiful hair. And one of your daughters has your hair, right?
Yes,
Nikki has the red hair.
And Tommy's graduating from college next weekend.
Yes, he's been doing it while he's been working, right?
Yes.
I don't know. Well, great. Yes. Good for him. Another something else for you to go to.
That's another special event for me to go to.
Okay.
Goodness gracious, we have a creature coming at us over here.
Look at this. They're getting ready to open up, I guess.
How's that for a segue?
It's starting around 10 o'clock. Thank you very much, Sue Light. Good
My
luck.
My pleasure.
Keep busy.
Enjoy the day.
Okay, right. Bye-bye.
is my distinct pleasure to introduce to you the person who will introduce our dignitaries gracing our stage today. Please welcome the Director of the Clinton County Office for the Aging, Kathy Felding.
Thank you very much. Welcome to all of you. I'm delighted to see so many of you, and I know many more will be arriving during the course of the morning. I want to acknowledge the very special role that's been played by a planning committee, which has been meeting all year long to make sure that this day is effective and joyful in every single way. And I know you'll want to join me in thanking them as well. The individuals who are responsible are co-chairpersons Kathleen Hazel and Nancy Mann. Also, committee members Jean Chase, Jan Dean, Sandra Foley, who are all connected with the nutrition program sponsored by the Senior Council, Marty Gilbert, who is an advocate for the elderly, Corey Lazarus, Betty Rabideau, Ella Recor, Kay Sholey, and Shirley O'Connell. And thank you, one and all, for your great contribution to our day. I'd like to turn the program over now to Father McCaslin.
In the spirit of the senior celebration, I'd just like to have three little prayers. One, an acknowledgement of God's gifts, his natural gifts to us, in thanksgiving for these gifts, and then for the senior citizens and all those workers who have worked so hard to put on this beautiful demonstration we have today. Lord and Father, all holy, we bless you. For your word and power have made all things, and your gift has given us what we need to live. Grant that in obedience to your law and will, your faithful people may always use these created things in the spirit of gratitude and thanksgiving. Lord God, from the abundance of your mercy, enrich your servants and safeguard them. Strengthened by your blessing, may they always be thankful to you and bless you with unending joy. And for God's blessing upon all our senior citizens, for those people who work so hard to make their lives happier, and for all those people who have worked so very hard to make this day possible for them, such a great accomplishment I've never seen it in all my life. It's the first one. Bless your people, Lord, who wait for the gift of your compassion. Grant that what they desire by your inspiration, they may receive through your goodness. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen.
We have a number of public officials who are honoring us with their presence today, and I'd like to introduce them at this time. They're on the stage, and would you please stand as your name is called. Mayor of Plattsburgh, Clay Rabideau.
Hey!
Mayor of the City of Keysville, James Finnegan.
Hey!
Supervisor Arthur Lafayette. Clinton County Administrator William Bazel. Legislator from Area 10, Donald Garrett.
Yay!
Legislator from Area 8, Gladys Perry.
Yay!
From the State Office for the Aging, Robert Trepoletti.
Yay!
Assemblyman Chris Ortlock.
Yay!
And Senator Ronald Stafford. You'll be meeting our honored guests who are award recipients just a later in the program. At this moment, I'd like to invite our state representatives to bring their greetings to you.
As I was sitting down, the button came off the front of my coat, so if anybody wants to offer to give me a hand putting it back on, I'd appreciate it. Thank you very much. It's so good to be home. It's good to be with people that we haven't seen in a while. It's good to see so many of you out here today. I'd like to commend the Plattsburgh High School Band and their director, Linda McCara, and let's all give them a big hand. Senator Stafford and I and our colleagues in Albany were graced by their playing about 2 weeks ago in Albany, as they do every year, and they are really a credit to this community, as are all of the seniors and those who work for them. Extending greetings from the state of New York, those of us who work for you in Albany, this gives us pause to think of all the programs and all the times that we have fought for those programs over the years, and this gathering today is really a fine testament to the value of our public sector being involved in senior programs. The Office of the Aging is here represented, and all I can say today is that we continue to renew our support and our enthusiasm for the programs like this one that make life valuable, that bring us all together, and that make it sure that the young people receive the benefit of the wisdom of everybody in this community to age 100 and beyond. So I thank you all for inviting me to share this day with you, and congratulations to all of you.
Thank you, Mr. Ortloff. Senator Stafford?
Thank you, Kathy, Father Howard, friends on the platform, and friends all. I think I get the message. It's not every place that you speak that they have a clock like that. But I think that tells us something. My close friend Don Guerin will be giving the keynote address. And Don, I know what it's like to be the speaker and have everybody else the speaker. But I would say this, as Chris has said, it certainly is very, very encouraging. It's just tremendous to see you all here listening, as has been pointed out by the Plattsburgh High School Band, who has done so well. All of the people here who have made it possible, hours and hours, days and days, weeks and weeks of work have gone into this. I would share with you that in this day and age, we're very interested in adding years onto life. I went through an experience where I was very interested and hopeful that I would have some additional years, I assure you. But you people, the people who made this possible, are really adding life into so many years, if you think about it. And you're the people who have been involved in your community. Consideration. I would say very, very quickly, you're the type of person. It seems about 10 years ago, two families drove across the United States because they were leaving a paper mill on the West Coast. They were coming to a paper mill on the East Coast. The first family arrived first at the post office. They said, "What kind of a community is this?" And the person they asked, sitting on a bench, and he looked up and said, "What kind of a community did you move from?" She said, the mother said, "It was terrible. We didn't like it. We didn't go to church in that community. The school wasn't good. We just didn't care for anything." And the lady said, "But I asked you, what kind of a community is this that we're moving into?" He said, "Unfortunately for you and us, you're moving into the same type of community." Very quickly, about 15 or 20 minutes later, the other family arrived. Mind you, they came from the same town. And this time the dad said, "What kind of a community is this?" This gentleman sitting on the bench. He said, "Well, what kind of a community did you move from?" We loved it. We were very involved. We had a tremendous church. We had tremendous civic organizations. We were very involved. In fact, the kids have been crying all across the country that we're leaving. But I asked him, "What kind of a community is this?" He said, "Fortunately for you, fortunate for the community, you moved into the same type of community." And a lesson you people have been the type that have made the great communities. I look forward to our working together. Thank you.
Thank you, Senator Stafford. I'd like to call now on our Master of Ceremonies, Frank Tortorelli.
Thank you, Kathy. Our next scheduled speaker from the New York State Office for the Aging, Mr. Bob Trefilet.
Well, thank you very much for inviting me to participate. First of all, I'd like to thank both the Clinton County Office for the Aging and the Senior Citizens Council for inviting me to participate in today's celebration. In particular, once again, I'd like to recognize the efforts of Nancy Maynard and Kathleen Hazel for their work in putting this affair together. I bring you greetings from Jane Gould, the Director of the State Office for the Aging. She sends her congratulations to all those individuals who will be acknowledged today for the assistance they provide to their fellow senior citizens. You know, it's not very often that we are able to stop our daily routines to take the time to show the appreciation of those people who go the extra mile. In my travels and duties as an aging services representative, I work directly with many counties. Let me tell all of you, the seniors of this county are extremely fortunate to have such a devoted and determined group of individuals from the Clinton County Office for the Aging, to the Advisory Council, right through to the county legislature, who really do go the extra mile to assist the county's senior population to enjoy life to the fullest. However, today's celebration is for those seniors who deliver the meals, who make the daily phone calls, who take their friends to the doctors, who grocery shop for their buddies. Without these individuals, all the funds that are provided by the federal government, by the state government, and the county government would not be used as effectively as they are. To those persons, I applaud you. Enjoy today. Take the opportunity to visit the many booths that are set up by the service providers. If you can, identify one service that will help you enjoy life a little better. But most of all, have fun, eat, drink, and be merry. It's your day, enjoy it. Thanks again, and God bless you.
Thank you very much, Bob. It's my pleasure now to introduce today's keynote speaker. He is the liaison to the Office for the Aging. He's a Clinton County legislator, and I count myself very fortunate. He's also a personal friend of mine. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Don Garrett.
Yay! Hi, Don.
As a personal friend of Frank Tortorelli's, I've got to tell you a story about Frank. One day, Joe Bornstein, who many of you know, is a Jewish person in our community and a well-known person in the community, and Frank were having an argument. Frank being a Catholic, Joe being a Jew, they were arguing whether priests knew more than rabbis. Frank seemed to be getting the best of the argument when Joe said, "Well, if priests know more than rabbis, it's because you Catholics tell them everything." Then my good friend Father McCaslin here, I'll tell a story on him that I heard. It seems he was telling his congregation in Cherubusco that on the following Sunday he was going to preach on lying. He asked them, by way of preparation, to read the 17th chapter of St. Mark's Gospel. When Sunday came, Father McCaslin asked his congregation, "All you who have read the 17th chapter, please raise your hands." Numerous hands went up throughout the congregation. Father McCaslin looked over the congregation, paused for a moment, and said, "The Gospel of St. Mark now has only 16 chapters. I will now proceed with my sermon on lying." I've had the privilege of campaigning with Senator Stafford many times, and I'll never forget the time when Ron was campaigning in a nearby town, and he called on the local minister for his support. "Before I decide," said the minister, Senator Stafford, "I'd like to know if you partake of intoxicating beverages." Said Ron, the great politician that he is, "Tell me, is this an inquiry or an invitation?" little more than 15 years ago, the students at Long Beach College in California elected their spring festival queen. They chose a woman with looks, intelligence, personality, and campus-wide popularity. So what, you may be saying? Their choice to typify what was described as eternal inner beauty and strength was Pearl Taylor. Pearl Taylor was a 90-year-old part-time student. Several months prior to that time, the people of Raleigh, North Carolina, elected Isabella Cannon as their mayor. So what, you say? Isabella Cannon was a 73-year-old senior citizen. When someone told 89-year-old Dorothy Duncan that she had lived a full life, she responded tartly by saying, "Don't you past tense me." In our society, which I believe is youth-oriented, the message often sent to senior citizens is their usefulness ends at 65, if not sooner. Many, like Dorothy Duncan, realize this is nonsense and go right on leading a productive life. Our actress Jessica Tandy won an Academy Award, you'll remember, at 80 for her performance in Driving Miss Daisy. The late Congressman Claude Pepper of Florida still actively championed the rights of elderly and poor at 88. I guess the moral of these stories is that not all senior citizens are isolated, sick, and lonely. Many are active, interested, and involved. My remarks today concern with the topic, the politics of the aging, or senior power. Senior power became a rallying cry in the 1970s as senior citizens recognized their ability to influence government. Remember the chief accomplishments of pro-age special interest groups. We had the passage of the Older American Act in 1965 and Medicare in 1966. The decades of the 70s and 80s brought forth cries of great power and slogans for older Americans like, "Don't agonize, organize." Today here in Clinton County, more than one-fourth of the persons registered to vote, like many of you, are 60 years of age. And as such, you can achieve results that profoundly affect your well-being, such as better health care, improved housing, just to mention two. Much has been done to help the seriously handicapped, and much more can be done for you, such as providing more senior housing, convenient public transportation, free educational opportunities, better home health care, and greater assistance in paying a high cost of prescription drugs. I had a senior citizen in my legislative district, 83 years old, living on $700 a month income, tell me recently that she had been to the drugstore on three occasions in the last 3 weeks and had to pay $212 for prescription drugs because she had not yet been eligible for EPIC. The 1990 census revealed that almost 16,000 people in Clinton County are senior citizens 60 years of age. While the 60-year-old population makes up 19% of the county's population, 26% of the county's registered voters are 60 years of age, and most of you do indeed vote. The voting power of senior citizens in this county is greater than the actual numbers would indicate, and I'm pleased to report that in my legislative district, 32% of the registered voters are 60 years of age, and this is the largest percentage of registered voters over the age of 60 of any of the county's 10 legislative districts. I'm also proud that I've been a member of AARP now for almost 9 years, and that in 13 months and one day, I will be an official senior citizen, and I'm looking forward to it. As an important part of Clinton County's population, you live in an important and exciting age when political power or the ability to achieve desired goals for your towns, villages, the county, the city, and your school district will benefit you. They can be achieved in a number of ways. You can support candidates for office who show some interest in you. You can make telephone calls at election time, address envelopes, and canvass house to house. But guess what I'm saying is the organized power of senior citizens will grow every year, and I hope most of you will want to be part of the action. An article written by Ross Baker from American Demographics that was featured in the recent issue of Modern Majority, which which all we AARP members get, noted that we are living in an age of explosion of centenarians. Baker points out that the number of Americans aged 100 years or older is projected to grow from 45,000 today to more than 77,000 in the year 2000. Added Baker tongue-in-cheek, by the year 2050, 2.4 million baby boomers may be saying, never trust anyone under 99. And if the projections are accurate, Willard Scott's birthday greetings to centenarians will eventually take over the whole two-hour Today show. In Baker ads, you will see bumper stickers on cars that will run the entire length of the car fender that will read, let me tell you about my great-great-great-grandchildren. You know, George Bernard Shaw once said, I see things as they are and I ask why, but I dream things that never were and I ask why not. This is a task of every generation. And please remember that the road ahead will be faced with many setbacks. But it takes courage to be different, and it takes courage to stand up and be counted, and to live a life in the present tense. It took courage for Columbus to insist that the world was round, and mostly everyone else said it was flat. It took courage for James Meredith, now a senior citizen like you, to walk along US Highway 51 from Memphis, Tennessee to Jackson, Mississippi, 33 years ago, on the assumption that if he could do it safely, it would prove to his fellow blacks that they had nothing to fear in registering to vote. It takes courage to give it yourself. A Lebanese poet once said, you give little when you give of your personal possessions. It is when you give of yourself that you truly give. I have occasionally wondered, as I know you have, how often many people seriously consider their full responsibilities to give of themselves to serve others. Most people believe that public service is the sole responsibility of those elected to office. Many individuals believe their duty to their communities ends when they fulfill their obligation of voting. We have a responsibility to our communities that goes beyond mere voting for elected officials. By joining in community enterprises and cooperating in undertakings, you can help make your communities more progressive and of greater service to the people who live there. I believe you, as senior citizens, should exert political power in many ways, serving in elected or appointed office. People over 60 years old can serve in office, too. We need more senior citizens taking an active role in all areas of local government and in school boards. If you are willing to seek election, if you're not willing to seek election, please seek an appointment to an important commission or study group. Tell your legislator, your town board member, that you want to serve. You know, political power is a way to work within the system to gain political influence. But the term activism connotes more than simply joining or voting an organization. The term political activist brings to mind an individual who is politically involved in a fuller, more energetic way and uses energy as a means to push for change. As senior citizens, I believe that you should follow the traditional route of voting, but also consider these other political activities. Join political campaigns for local, state, and federal officials and legislators who support your interests. Register nursing home and old age residents and those confined to their homes as absentee ballots. The number of elderly people we meet who are confined to their homes are not given the opportunity to vote in many cases. We don't know about it until it's too late to register them. Try to find them and register them. Lobby intensely for programs to benefit you. Attend local government and school board meetings and see how the public's business is conducted. And don't be afraid to speak during the public part of the meeting. Participate in petition drives. Help with the political education of others in your group. Lead voter registration drives for senior citizens. I'm sure you realize that the more seniors register to vote, the more who vote, the more we will consider your needs because of your potential strength on election day. Such political power is a matter of giving or getting. It's not one-sided, and it shouldn't be limited to a handful of people. When one reads the biographies of the world's most successful peoples, we think they were born geniuses because they did things that were important to us. But let me give you a few examples. St. Thomas Aquinas, who was one of the most influential of the scholastic theologians, and as many of you know, is patron of all Catholic schools, was known as the dumb ox because they considered him so dull-witted. But this dumb ox developed to be one of the most brilliant thinkers the Catholic Church has ever produced. And Harry Truman and Abraham Lincoln failed miserably as storekeepers but became president. And Franklin Roosevelt was elected president more times than any other person in history, but he was defeated as a candidate for vice president in 1920. And the great Jesse Owens, who in the 1936 Olympics won 4 gold medals, broke 2 Olympic records, tied one, and had a hand in establishing another. Did you know that he worked his way through Ohio University as an elevator operator because he couldn't obtain an athletic scholarship? Can you imagine the gain to our communities, our state, or our nation if everyone would use his or her capacities to the full extent of their ability? Such abilities are found in each and every one. Through these abilities, we can make our lives happy for ourselves and useful for others. We need only to devote ourselves to work and look upon our special vocation as an opportunity to serve and a means to gain the greatest happiness in life. Happy, productive senior citizens don't necessarily refuse to retire from their jobs, but they do refuse to retire from life. The late General Douglas MacArthur, on the occasion of his 75th birthday, said, and I quote, "Youth is not entirely a time of life. It is a state of mind. It is a temper of the will, a quality of the imagination, a vigor of emotions. Nobody grows old merely by living a number of years. People grow old by discerning their ideals." End of quote. Thank you for inviting me to the senior celebration. I hope you have many years of happiness, good health, and a productive life in working for your communities. Thank you.
As I recall, if history teaches me correctly, it was Winston Churchill who was thrown out of something like 7 schools when he was a young man. And he certainly was one of the most important people in our lifetime. We missed a little something earlier in the program, and music has never been an interruption in my life, but I'd like to ask if they will please, because they've worked very hard, and their music is wonderful to hear, that Linda McCara and the Plattsburgh High School Band will now honor us with a Lexington March.
Thank you very much, Plattsburgh High Band. At this this time now I would like to introduce Mr. Trefoletti again, who will be making some special presentations. Bob Trefoletti.
Thank you. At this time, I'd like to get to two special awards to two very, very special individuals. First of all, is Rhonda Mean here yet? Okay, I'm gonna announce her award. She here? Rhonda's here? Okay, we'll wait. There she is, hey. Come on up here, Rhonda, would you please? Let's give her a round of applause and as she works her way up to the stage. Rhonda Mean. Rhonda Mean's a home care worker. She's the recipient of the Outstanding Service Award. She's a home care worker with North Country Home Services. She's with us this morning between client appointments. We're pleased that she could be here for this special occasion. Here she comes now, once again, Rhonda Mead. Hi, congratulations. I'd like to present you with this award. It says, in appreciation, Rhonda Mead, for inspiring and dedicated service to the well-being of older New Yorkers and their families, signed by the State Director, Jane Globe. Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
Would you like to say a comment?
I would just like to thank everybody out there. I enjoy senior citizens very much, and I also enjoy all the great stories. Thank you.
Yay! All right. Congratulations.
William Dooley. William Dooley is an adult daycare volunteer. He's been giving the Outstanding Service Award. Now, Bill very much regrets that he cannot be with us today and wish to express his deep appreciation for the recognition given to him. I believe that someone's here to speak for him. Okay. Well, I'll read the citation that Mr. Dooley got. It says, in appreciation of William Dooley, for inspiring and dedicated service to the well-being of older New Yorkers and their families. Let's give him a round of applause in absentia, please. Yeah. Mr. William Dooley, Adult Daycare Volunteer Outstanding Service Award. Now I'd like to ask Don to come up and help me give out the state awards, please.
I'd like to have my colleague, Linus Perry, fellow legislator.
Yay.
I shouldn't say fellow. And as we give these county awards, what Senator Stafford, Assemblyman Orloff, Mayor Rapidoo, Mayor Finnegan, County Administrator Bingo, Supervisor Lefebvre, would you come forward and congratulate these people, please? Might step forward and do that. Appreciate it. I won't read the proclamation, but our chairperson, Melvin Bob Bruno, proclaimed the month of May as Older Americans Month. And I'm sure you all have a copy of the proclamation. Certainly our recipients will get it. And I guess Kathy tells me I'm supposed to read the individual resolution. And the first one congratulates Rhonda Mead. Yes. Whereas Rhonda Mead of Mason Street, Morrisonville, employee of North Country Home Services, has selected to receive the Office for the Aging 1994 award. Ms. Mead, serving as a home care aide under the ISIP program, has gained the respect of her contemporaries through her acts of kindness and her professional manner. And whereas her clients have expressed words of praise for her ability to help them adapt to the quality of life. And it then says, be it resolved that the legislature congratulates Rhonda. We commend her for setting an example for those in her profession. Mr. Dooley, as was mentioned earlier, is not able to be here. The next award goes to the great Joseph McGrath. Joe? Everybody knows Joe. Whereas Mr. Joseph Joseph P. McGrath of 19 West 4th Street, Plattsburgh, has been honored by the New York State Senate and Assembly Committees on the Aging for being selected by Clinton County for outstanding contributions to senior citizens. And whereas Mr. McGrath has provided service to our community with an emphasis on service for the aging. Whereas through his many civic activities, which include helping seniors file for health insurance benefits, serving as a tax consultant for AARP and its members, participating in the Plattsburgh Rotary Club, serving as a member of the Public Library, the Senior Volunteer Program Board, and being the past chairperson of the Lifeline Committee, Mr. McGrath takes a hands-on approach to understanding the needs and life circumstances that have an impact on our senior citizens. Be it resolved that Joseph Clinton County Legislature recognizes Joseph P. McGrath on being selected to receive the Outstanding Contributions by a Senior Citizen Award, and be it further resolved that we publicly commend Mr. McGrath for his tireless efforts and willingness to serve our senior citizens. He's our number one volunteer.
Yay! All right.
Our next award goes to Carl Kramer, the 1994 Senior Citizen of the Year Award, and here to accept the award is his better half, Mrs. Kramer.
Yay! All right!
Whereas our community is given an opportunity each year to select an individual who embodies a spirit of cooperation, generosity, and volunteerism. Whereas this year, Dr. Carl Kramer of 25 Prospect Avenue, Plattsburgh, has been chosen for recognition by the Senate and Assembly Standing Committees on the Aging. Whereas Dr. Kramer's volunteer services began years ago and have steadily increased since his retirement, including service on the Board of Directors and holding the presidency of the Northern New York Senate, serving on the Board of Directors of St. Lawrence Psychiatric Center, and holding the position of President, serving on the New York State Board of Visitors, and being an active member and chairperson of the Plattsburgh Human Rights Commission. Whereas Dr. Kramer has received numerous honors, including the Rotary International Service Above Self Award, the Paul Harris Fellowship Award, the United Way Distinguished Citizen Award, the Lillian B. Retke Award, and the Northern New York Distinguished Board Service Award. Whereas Dr. Kramer's sincere consideration for others and willingness to give unselfishly his time and talents are characteristics we admire and strive to emulate, be it resolved that the legislature takes this opportunity to congratulate Carl Kramer as the 1994 Clinton County Senior Citizen of the Year. And we publicly commend Dr. Kramer for his efforts on behalf of the senior citizens of Clinton County.
Yay! All right.
Ms. Hurkin, she wishes to speak. You're going to speak for Carl in a moment.
All right.
I'm a person of few words, and at this time, my husband has a few words. On behalf of my husband, I'm most pleased to accept this award. He has asked me to thank you for this honor, and he's also especially pleased to be identified with an outstanding community servant as Joe McGrath. Thank you again.
Hey, all right.
That concludes our awards program. I want to thank Gladys, my colleague, for helping me, and thank you, gentlemen, for congratulating the recipients.
The next feature of our program is a presentation to the Senior Citizens Council of Quilters, and it will be my pleasure to mention their names, as I understand that someone is going to assist me to dispense with something we have for them, as I understand. Is that right, Kathleen? The quilters will come up. I'm telling this to you as it is being told to me. So I will be pleased to mention their names. The quilters are Jan Pauley, Dorothy Downey, Nancy Clegg, Madeline Gagnon, and Iris Rowe. Let's have a round of applause for these people, please. Accompanying them, Kathleen Hazel.
Blake.
calling Florence Gravel. Emmett Buckley. Ruth Edgerton. Sophia Bobolu. Hazel Jeanette. Emma Bouvier. Rachel Squillo. Lillian Rock. Hazel Pierce. Clara Pollock. Alice Sandberg. And for our 101-year-old Mary Cavanaugh. Violet Garrow. Myrtle Robert. Alice Renedette. Melvina Agnew. Mabel Stratton. Hazel Wood. Wilford Rock. Floyd Lashway. Elizabeth Hart. Cora Casalonis. Margaret Garrow. Marguerite Bashaw. Flo Harris. Eva Tulowski. Ruth Dupree. Nettie Santori. Okay. Is there someone here who is 90 or over whose name has not been mentioned?
There's probably some of them that didn't hear.
Maxine Klein, welcome. Mrs. Klein. Mrs. Klein is one of our living treasures, and we welcome you today. We will have an award for you. Are there other folks here? Lillian Scott, would you raise your hand, please? We will have an award for you as well. Are there others? Alice Roth. Do I have that correct? Very good. Are there others? I'm happy to find so many men here today.
Thank you.
numbers to announce.
We didn't hear when they were handing out those, but obviously this lady got one. She's got the envelope right here. That means this lady is at least 90 years old. Is that right?
I'm 92.
92 years old and a graduate of Jay-Z Central?
No, ma'am.
Oh,
no.
Where?
I graduated from the high school when it was a Plattsburgh Normal School.
In Plattsburgh. All right. And your name? Look, it says right there. Florence Gravel, Jay-Z, New York, still going to those basketball games?
I am. I am. And he will bow to it.
What?
He will bow to it. I always go.
You move him right out of the way, do you? Did you get your picture at the ball game?
No. I sat right in the front seat beside Harold Humer.
Okay. Harold still makes the games, too?
Yep.
Yeah. Do you make all the games? Your grandson is a coach in one of them, right?
Not from here. He's coaching down. He was from here.
Here we go.
But he is down near New York City now.
Oh, is he? Oh, I didn't know that.
He's coaching a game down there, and he was married this spring.
Oh, I didn't know that either. Well, congratulations to him and to you, too. You may have a great-great-grandchild, great-great-great or something here pretty soon.
I have got one. I've got two.
You have?
And another one on the way. Excuse me.
Do you teach the mothers how to take care of those young kids?
No. I just babysit for them.
Oh, and you keep right out of it otherwise. Well, listen, thank you very much for talking to us. And you're going to be here long today?
I have no idea.
Don't know. Till you get tired.
Your prize winners for this particular announcement.
Florence Gravel, Jay-Z, one of our great citizens of the community of Jay-Z, New York. Thank you, Mrs. Gravel. Nice seeing you.
Goodbye.
What's your
Northern Tier person right here? And this is Mrs. Florence?
Florence Mitchell.
Mitchell. And this is her...
Her granddaughter is married to me, Kathy Cavanaugh.
All right.
My name's Frank Woodward.
All right. Your maiden name was Roberts.
Yes.
All right. And this lady owned the house that was raised back in Champlain, New York, where my daughter and son-in-law Dan and Sue Belrose live on Main Street. I forget their new number. I think it's 1231 or something. And you lived there back in the early 1900s.
Yes.
How old? Can you tell me how old you are?
How old am I?
Yeah.
Only 98.
98?
And I drove my shoveling.
Oh.
I paint my house. I've got an 8-room house, and I do all my own work.
You don't live alone.
Yes, I do all my
you
work.
You live
too.
Alone?
She lives
Why
alone.
Why not? I shovel snow.
She takes care of her own house, and she shovels her own walk in the wintertime, and she walks to church. Is it every morning now, Florence?
Not every
Not every morning, but
not,
most
not
mornings
later,
she'll walk down to church.
On the ice.
Back.
Now, is Dave your son?
Yes.
Dave Mitchell.
Dave Mitchell, who was married to that Jeanette Coonan?
No, that's right. No,
that's wrong, David?
No, David is Janet Coonan.
Janet Coonan, right?
Yes.
Yes.
Yeah,
Janet, what did I say?
Jeanette.
Okay, Janet.
Doesn't matter.
Yes, and they used to have the ski shop down here in Plattsburgh, and now they're commuting between Northern Tier and Florida, don't they?
Yes.
You go to Florida in the winter?
No. I don't like Florida.
You don't like Florida?
Too hot.
I'm with you. I don't need hot either. Well, you certainly look good, Mrs. Mitchell.
You're going to tell them your age, Florence?
She did.
She
98.
Already told
I asked her, yes. Yeah,
she was 98 in February.
Unbelievable, huh?
She has her own summer camp that she opens every year, and in summertime she's out on the lake.
I shovel my sidewalk way down to the cement.
Have you known this lady over here before? You have your own garden?
No.
Do you know Florence Gravel? Two Florence? Mrs. Mitchell, she was from Champlain?
I was from Champlain.
Jay-Z.
I live in Jay-Z Landing. No.
She's 92, and this lady's 98. And my daughter lives in the house where she was raised in Champlain. I forgot that, yes.
My father had gone.
Don't believe a word
of that. Well, now, is that nice to put on TV?
Well, it's very good to be.
And right where it's true, right?
We warn everybody.
Well, listen, thank you very, very much. It was so nice you could get down here. And well, you get down, but you go all over. Yeah. What do you do for hobbies except shovel snow?
I say a lot of prayers.
You say a lot of prayers?
Yes.
You pray for people? Would
for
you
everybody.
Say one for me
yes,
sometime?
I pray for everybody.
Okay, well, you know who really needs it? That guy right there behind the camera. You know who that is? That's Calvin Kastein. You know yes. Carl Kastein, his father? No, well, that's Calvin Kastein. His grandfather was Robert Kastein. Used to live in Champlain, yeah. And that's
what
Calvin.
What was the first name?
Robert, right? It was Robert. And he's married to Judy Engtill from Rouse's Point. You probably know, you know the Engtills in Rouse's Point. You've been, have you lived in that, in this area all your life?
Champlain and Rouse's Point. I was born in Champlain.
Yes, yeah. 98 years ago.
She was born in Champlain and she's lived in Rouse's Point since when? 1920 what?
1926.
Her husband built a house on Clinton Street that they live in, and she's lived in that house since it was built.
And I painted that house.
How many children did you have?
Four.
Four children. Are they all still living?
No. One died.
All right. Well, thank you very much for talking to us, and you were certainly an honored, whatever they got here, honored guest today, and we hope to see you again very soon.
Yes.
Right. Bye.
Well, you're never going to make me talk.
Oh, we will. As soon as whenever there's food around, you'll always see this guy right here on my left. See? Well, I'm going to start off right here with Alfred LaFountain from Champlain. How are you, Alfred?
Good, very good.
When you're not working up at the Mission Center, you're down here getting food.
Yeah.
You've been to these before down here?
Yes. I never miss one.
You never miss one. And who's the lady here?
Agnes LaFontaine.
Now, Agnes, you're usually serving food, I remember, at school. You worked there for how many years?
Oh, 28 years.
28 years. And today they're going to wait on you.
Right.
We see her son now and then, Bobby, down here. I don't know if he's been on TV with us. I think he has. He was saying he sees our show and he likes the show now and then. So, are you active in the senior group?
Well, we belong to the Moores group.
You know what Calvin said? He said these people probably lied about their age so they think they're 60 years old. No?
I don't think so.
Your maiden name was LaFontaine?
Bichard.
Oh, Bichard. Oh, excuse me, yes. And if you're not Bichard, if you're not a Bichard, or well, that's the big name in Champlain, Bichards and the Tremblays, I guess in Castines too, right?
Oh, no.
No, you don't know that. All right. Well, Alfred, what else is going to happen? Why are you going to be here?
Hello?
You're going to make it till 10:30 tonight?
No.
You aren't going to be here for the 40s music? No? I thank you very much for talking to us. We'll go over and see how the... We got some gentlemen here. We don't find many older gentlemen that come to these things. We mostly see there are more women at these things than there are men. But we got some more men here now. All right, give me our name right here. Can you look at our camera right there? We'll get your face here. The name is LaVonture.
Yes, right.
Andres LaVonture, my neighbor on Church
Francis.
Street. I'm sorry, Andrew. I'm sorry. Francis LaVonture down the street from me. I'm sorry. And
I'm Ray Juno.
Ray Juno, who used to live across, he still lives across from where my wife was when I used to be going out with my wife.
That's right.
And I'd park in the front there sometimes pretty late. I hope I didn't keep you awake back then.
I don't know.
There weren't many people that came to your house to see your girls, because you don't have any girls, do you?
That's right.
Your boys were always somewhere. How many children?
Eight.
Eight children, all boys in and around. They're the ball players from the Champlain area, the Junos, for years. And you got any granddaughters?
Got lots of grandchildren, that's for sure.
Granddaughters?
Daughters, yeah.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, got lots of that.
Have you been down to one of these before, like this, at this place?
Well, not like this, but over at the Airbus we had.
Yeah. You got a good crowd, it'd be a good day.
I like this here. I like partying.
You do like parties,
yeah?
Huh?
I like parties.
All right, you like parties too?
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right, so Andres, have you been in the senior group before, right along? Do you belong to the senior group, or is this mainly the day?
No,
You belong to? Good place to meet other people that you've known for years. Okay, well, we're talking with two more of Champlain's Northern Tier. Thank you, gentlemen. Northern Tier represented and by men, too. You were both two men sitting here. Remember the long talk we had with Paul Vogan, our formerly superintendent of schools. Paul, good morning.
Good morning.
And I didn't know I was going to see you here this morning. You've been down in these on a regular basis?
Oh, no, this is the first one they've had.
Oh, this is the first one like this?
Yes, but it'll be a yearly event now, I understand.
Okay. And our man on our left is?
Leonard Rasko.
Yes, and they tell me you were the teacher for how many years?
35 years, 30? Industrial arts and Moores.
In Moores and Northeastern.
Yes.
And I said I didn't really had met him at school anyway. You taught industrial arts all those years?
Yes.
Yep. So Mr. West, Andy, succeeded you?
No, Andy was with me. I went over and moved over in Northeastern when they merged in 70.
Okay.
Had Andy and Clark and myself over there in Northeastern after the merger.
Where were you from originally?
Saranac Lake.
Oh, you didn't come very far, did you?
No,
huh?
That's great. Down the hill a little bit.
Yep, very, very good. So, did anyone tell you that they saw you on TV and talking about the Moores area when we had our story?
Oh, a few.
A few tell you?
Saw too much.
Yeah, well, I'll tell you, it's good. They'll be around for a long, long time. Many people will see it. I've heard many comments about it. And we're very pleased that we had talked with you. All right, so you're down here for all day? You're going to make the whole day?
No, after we eat, we're going
to
run.
Oh, they came to eat is what it was all about, see? That's why they had the speeches first, see, so they could get the... You're going to eat and run?
We're going to Victor Ouellette's wake.
Oh, I've got to go tonight, yes.
And then Lawrence Upton died, too, so we lost two more citizens.
Oh. See, yesterday's paper, I think, said that it was only last night wake and today was a funeral, but they've corrected it.
No.
So I'll be over tonight to see him, too. You've lost two people.
This afternoon, tonight.
Right.
Oh. I don't know about Upton's. I think it's Sunday, the funeral. I think there's calling hours for more.
As you get older, there's less and less friends still around, right?
That's the way it works.
But there's a lot of people. I was surprised at how many people. We just talked to a 98-year-old lady, Mrs. Mitchell from Rouse's Point.
You know how many more women over 90
Well, yes. Well,
about 10 to 1.
I know that. Well, that's good for the men now. They got a good choice.
We must have treated them awfully well to this.
That's what it
so
is.
Long.
That's what it is, yes. Yep. But that don't speak well for them because the men drop off.
They must have deserved it, otherwise they wouldn't have given them.
That's right, because we worked so hard for them. That's what it is. Thank you very much, Mr. Rasko. Which high school team do you cheer for?
High school?
Yeah, he asked me, which high school team?
I don't cheer for any anymore.
You don't? Well, why did he ask me that to ask you? Do you know?
Well, maybe I cheer for Westport. My son's coach down there.
Your son is the... That's why he's asking you that, huh?
It might be. I don't know.
All right. Do you ever see him at the Westport games?
No.
When they go to Chazy, do you go to the game?
I went late yesterday.
Oh, the baseball.
Yeah.
All right.
Softball. Yes. Girls.
Oh, the girls team. All right. Westport.
That's
LaSalle's used to be there too. Yeah, the Cliff LaSalle was there with his group.
Beauvais is there now.
Beauvais.
Been there for years.
Okay. All right, well, that's why he's cheering for Westport, huh?
Well, sure. Closest I can get.
All right. So now you're enjoying your retirement?
Oh, yes. Oh, yes.
You get together with this man once in a while?
I live right across the street from him.
Do you shovel each other's driveway when
No, you don't do that.
Oh, no. Nice seeing you. Talk to you later.
Okay, Bob.
Now, I don't think this lady knew she's going to see us today, so she's going to be very unprepared for this today, as prepared as she has been all over these various times with us. Peg Barcombe, how are you?
Good.
Good to see you out, and you, we haven't seen you for a while out in function.
No. I'm back at it again.
It's been a long winter.
Yep, long winter.
Are you down here with somebody else from Rouse's Point?
No, I'm alone.
You're alone by yourself here? All right, well, will you make it all day?
Well, I'm going to stay. I'm not going to stay for the buffet.
You're not going to stay for that music tonight, the 40s? No? You got your own record you can play.
But this is great. This is the best spot that they've ever had to have this. Because if it was at the base or up at the college, there wasn't enough parking.
Yep.
And here you can wander around. There's still plenty of seats. It's just great.
Yep.
This is a perfect place.
There's a lot. Look at the people here. They're expecting about 600. We were told for the luncheon, and maybe up 400 for tonight.
Yeah.
So forth. All right.
Yeah, and a lot will come just tonight too for the dancing and all. You know.
Will they be actual dancing or just music?
No,
they'll be
dancing. There's going to be line dancing.
Those women, a lot of women will be dancing with them with other women because there aren't that many older men at least that come around.
Well, they're supposed to be line dancing and all tonight.
Okay. All right, well, I'm still hearing, Peg, about the railroads and all the things, you know, about railroads and the people that talk about it. And one of these days, we were talking with Calvin, where we were saying we got to get it up to date with some of the engineers and so forth, you know, talk with them about that end of it.
Yeah.
And we've got to get back to you. I've got some more pictures of Rouse's Point that I want to go over with you. And nice seeing you.
You too.
Okay, Peg Barcombe, the former town historian for how long were you a historian?
8 years or so, the village, and then the town.
You know, someone asked me, they said, I'm doing a lot of study. He said, you ought to be one of the historians. I said, no. If I were the historian, you'd only have one. Now that you have one and I'm so interested, it makes two of us. There's two people gathering information now, you know?
Well, like, so I was gathering. I still get
you
all
still
kinds
do
of
it.
Calls
still
and do it. Yep. Letters and all, and I answer them, but I don't go out and get active in it, you know? Yep.
Well, I won't invite anybody to call you, but if I were out there and I wanted information, I would call Peg Barkov of Rouse's Point at 297 number, and it says Alice in the book, and she can help you out of the North area. I see you, Peg.
Yeah, you too.
It says JCEO, it doesn't say, you got to read the initials, Joint Council for Economic Opportunity. This is the director, is that correct name?
I'm program director.
Program director, and it's Sue Markham. If you remember, we talked with she and the people from the
Community Outreach Program.
A couple years ago,
that's
right?
That's right, it's been quite a while.
So how are things going with you?
Terrific. Now we have a new program, the Senior Outreach Program. So that's why we're here today, because we provide outreach services for the senior population.
What does
now.
That mean about outreach?
We do some door-to-door visiting. We're out in the field. We've got four workers who go out in the field door-to-door to talk to those seniors who are frail and may live at home and not be able to get out to these types of events. And then we've got two other outreach workers who do community work, either recruiting people to volunteer or performing some kind of service in the communities, or going out and speaking to large groups of seniors.
Now you have how many offices in the county?
We have 10 community outreach centers, which is different from our senior outreach program, but we all kind of work together.
Can I give you my pet peeve?
Okay.
In Champlain,
uh-huh.
My wife will be over in the office. She's on the committee.
I know Teresa well.
And I don't know how to call.
Ah.
So I look up JCEO and there is nothing. You have to look up the community outreach or something. Now, I would never think of that when I'm thinking of the JCEO. Couldn't you have an additional listing?
You know what? When was the last time you looked? Because in their new phone book...
I didn't look in the new one.
Aha, there you go.
I haven't called her lately.
In the most recent phone directory, we are listed under JCEO.
In addition?
No, under JCEO, and then it lists the outreach centers.
Someone must have heard me.
Somebody complained.
Well, that's what I call good service, Sue. I just mentioned it. You already got it taken
care of. You
got
it, Bob.
All right. Now, tell us a little bit about this once-a-month food that's available. That's through your office. A lot of people still don't realize that anybody can apply for that.
I think that's our biggest hurdle, is to get people to recognize that there are no income guidelines. It's an absolute bargain. We brought a food package here with us today just to show people what the actual cost is compared to the savings. This package, the savings, whoops, we have somebody standing right with
okay.
it. This package had about a $10 retail savings if you purchase it through the food co-op. And this was the actual package that we gave out in April.
Okay. I go up there. We've done at the Champlain Garage now, and we did about 120, I think, last month.
It really should be
200. It really should be at least 200.
It should be. I know the winter was a deterrent to some people because we had some awful hard weather to get out, but you cannot beat the bargain. It's regular food right from the groceries. There's just no broker involved, so we get a real discount on the price.
Right. So you come in once a month, you pay your money in ahead, $13.75. And then on the fourth Friday?
The Friday before the fourth Saturday.
The Friday? You can't say fourth Friday.
No, it's not
the Friday before the fourth Saturday.
Right.
That they issue
That's
the food?
That's the pickup.
And you, you got to buy it in your own town, or can you pick it up in any town?
Where you buy it is where you pick it up.
All right. So,
but it doesn't matter where you live.
All right. All right, anything else we should know that's new other than your outreach program?
Just that we have a great outreach program. And what people need to know is if they need an outreach worker to come to their home, they need to call JCEO at 561-6310.
6310. Now,
right.
How is the JCEO tied in today to this particular event?
Well, we're the fortunate people who have the senior outreach program in Clinton County. We're sponsored through the Office for the Aging for this program. And so we're here. We have a lot of seniors that we work with who are here today. And we've brought some of the over 90 seniors with us who are being honored.
Yes.
So it's really exciting.
We talked to Mrs. Gravel, 92. Mm-hmm. We talked to Mrs. Mitchell, 98.
Well,
in Rouse's Point.
I met her. I can't tell you the age of the two we brought because they wouldn't let me do that.
All right.
But they're definitely more than 90.
You must be very gratified with the crowd you have.
Oh, it's wonderful. Isn't it a great turnout?
Someone was just saying what a great place for it, too.
It is. I don't think there was another building that could have held this crowd, so it's absolutely super.
You know, when I first started talking to you, I didn't think you wanted to talk today, but you're doing very, very well. So once we get started.
Oh, people know I always talk. It was just give somebody else a turn. This
okay.
round.
Sue Markham, JCEO, Program Director. Thanks very much.
Thanks,
Sue.
Bob.
Right here.
Just like your age, Jack.
You know, we always talk about Henry White and all he does, but the one who really keeps him going is this lady right here, Viola.
Oh, no.
Hi. The queen of the king and queen of the Winter Festival from Moores, New York. What do you think?
Well, I think it's pretty nice. Because we didn't decide on that. Somebody else did.
Oh, all right. You know what I look here? I see there's four men at this table and you're the only lady. And you're not sitting very close to him either now. Are you kind of shopping here or something?
I guess so.
Yes. There's some nice looking men around here too.
They all belong to our drop-in.
They all belong to the drop-in.
Oh, no, nutrition.
Nutrition, huh?
Yeah, so we're all in the same group. And we got in late, so we sit here.
You didn't see the program?
Some of it, not all of it, some of it.
You going to stay till the very end and dance tonight?
I hope to.
And listen to the 40s music, yes?
Yes.
Well, very good. All right. That's Viola White. Her husband's sitting right over here. This is Mr. White. We better talk to him next or he'll never talk to me again. Henry White, good. Now, listen, we've been hearing here about this. Well, about this elevator again, and I thought that you didn't have enough money. How are you doing this?
Well, I got a grant from Senator Stafford, you know, to go over the board for this elevator. And I got to work through the Housing Trust Fund before I can get it going, because they got to know what's going on because they put up the grant for the building, you know? So I'm working on it. I got the Office for the Aging helping me, and we're getting it.
Are you going to get started soon?
Soon.
You're going to be actually getting underway?
We put it out for bids already. We got a bid.
Oh. Yeah. The price has gone up since probably?
It probably has.
Probably has.
Probably
well, I'm
has.
Sure. But you're all filled, all 11 units.
Yep. Yep.
That one of the newest, well, I guess it's not newest anymore. Altona's come in. Altona's the newest, but one of the ones that took a long time and did a lot of work with the senior citizens in the Moores area.
Yep.
Anything else new, Henry? You want to tell us?
No, I can't think of nothing. We're doing very nicely and we're happy. That's all that matters.
Does she keep you happy over there? That lady that keeps you happy?
She better.
All right. Henry White. This one says Jerry Miller. And where is Jerry Miller from?
I'm here, Nate, today.
You know, all right. So, Mr. Miller, you are from Moores?
Correct. Moores Forks.
Moores Forks. How long have you lived in Moores Forks? Oh, I don't want to get your age, but all your life?
85.
Oh, you're 85?
Monday, next Tuesday.
Pardon?
Next Tuesday, 85.
Are you related to that Miller there?
Oh, yeah, I guess so.
That a brother?
Yeah.
Are you brothers? You are my brother. All right, well, welcome to the celebration at the Hometown Cable. And how are you?
Pretty good.
Now, when I went to school with Reginald Miller. Was that his son?
My son.
Your son, Reggie. All right, good.
There's Homer.
Pardon?
Homer.
I know Homer and...
Irene.
Irene, we've talked to. Yeah, you have what, 8 kids? 8, huh? There were?
2 girls. And 6 boys.
And you've been well?
No, I've been in the hospital a little while. I've been coming good then.
Good. Okay. You enjoying the celebration?
Yes, I enjoy.
Have you walked around and see who's here yet?
I've walked around, yeah.
You see a lot of familiar faces?
Yes. Father McAsson.
Yes, he's here, yeah. He was there with you for nearly 10 years, wasn't he?
Yeah.
9 years, I think he was in...
Yeah, about 9 years. Yeah.
Okay. All right. Thank you much for talking to us. Leonard Miller, that is, I didn't give his name, from Moores, New York.
Moores Forks.
Well,
I live right here.
There's a difference, too, between Moores and Moores Forks. The whites are living in Moores, but the rest of them live in Moores Forks, right?
I live right near the town hall.
right near the town hall in Morris Forks, New York. We'll be right back. All right, I know that this is not Moores or Morris Forks. Maybe it was way back. Were you ever born in Moores or Morris Forks?
No, I wasn't born there, but I lived in
Moores. Did you live in Morris Forks?
In Moores, I mean.
Oh, another Moores. But for many years that we knew you, you were in Champlain, New York. Yes. Yeah. B-A-R-R-I-E-R.
40-some years.
Arthur, right there, has got several sons. One lives in Rouse's Point.
One in Rouse's Point, one in Cooperville.
Rady, who works for F.W. Myers, one of the customs brokers.
Yeah, and one is in Albany. And the other one, Roy, is for Cornell, Ithaca.
And you're in Plattsburgh now.
Yeah.
Okay.
I like it there.
You like it there. You enjoy these outings like this?
Oh, yeah.
Huh?
Oh, yeah.
Get to see the people you haven't seen for a while.
That's right.
Well, enjoy your meal. They're going to be serving you pretty soon. They're going to have chicken, I understand, right?
Chicken, that's good.
Yeah, chicken is very good. It won't, they say that if you eat chicken, you're very easy, can make your 70th birthday. You got to eat, yeah, if you eat chicken, it'll help you to get to be 70 years old.
And I'm fast.
Well, then you had a lot of chicken. Arthur Barrier, thank you very much, Art.
You're welcome.
You know, I kept talking about Moores all the time. They kept telling me, no, it was Moores Forks, but I think we're in Moores now. This is a Moores Nutrition. And who am I speaking with?
Sally Sample.
Sally Sample. And what is this here for, and what is this about?
This is a benefit for our nutrition site in Moores. We're selling chances on a lovely picnic basket. So we're trying to raise some money for our site.
Yeah. How much of the money in the Moores Nutrition site comes that you have to pick up yourself?
Well, like things for activities, you know, like we have parties, and I buy door prizes.
And then that's
like
the money
that.
You use for the program. Yeah. All right, do you work with them on a regular basis?
Yes, I've been there almost 9 years.
So you're in charge of the nutrition center,
yeah.
And you eat at the housing group?
No, we're at the fire station.
At the fire station. Oh, good facilities there too, aren't
yes,
they? That's as much a community center as it is a fire station.
Oh yes, a lot of local groups use it. For, you know, all kinds of.
In 9 years, you've been with them?
Yes, since it started.
How many people do you get on an average lunch period?
On an average, maybe 16 on a small day.
And they have to tell ahead of time that they're going
yes.
to come, right?
Reserve a day in advance.
Who do you want to tell out there, Moores Forks, and how they, what the advantage is, and how they would arrange to come in for the first time?
Well, we do a lot of advertising. They can just, call the center and make a reservation. Sometimes I find that people, when they first, once they do come, they always come back because they do. We play cards every day and
do all. Oh, you play cards and you don't just eat.
Oh no, we have activities every day.
Okay.
We play bingo.
Yeah.
A lot of different things.
All right.
You know, we have a good group that come there. We have some lovely people here today.
Yeah, it's a great crowd. Great turnout, huh? Great turnout, and I'm sure you'd like to see 30 people there every day, would you?
Yes, I would.
Have you anything to do with when you bring it to their homes? Do you bring any out to the homes?
Oh, yes, we have our daily.
So that if someone can't get out, they could still become part of the. And what are we talking about for money? It's about $1.50, $1.60?
$2.
$2. Donation that you get, and there's nutritious food, not just food.
Very, very good. I've eaten that meal for the last 9 years.
Well, if it can't be as trim as you are, I would have to eat some too, but I eat different kinds. I eat the flat calories, see?
Yeah.
But they don't come out flat once I've eaten them, see? Yeah. All right, there we go. Sally Sample, thank you very much for talking to us. And the syrup is also something they're taking chances on?
On the other end, no, I'm selling that for Sample Brothers.
Okay.
Which is my husband and his brother Alton.
And is that the sugar house right there?
Well, it's, yes.
Okay.
That's our sugar house.
That's your sugar house.
Well, similar to it.
Uh-huh.
So?
All right, well, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Sally Sample, Moores Nutrition Center. There's an awful lot of pastry at this table and brought my attention right over here. And we're at the West Shazy
Senior Citizens
Club, is that what you call it? And your name?
Shirley Ducharme.
Shirley Ducharme. That's a popular name. I know some other Shirley Ducharme. There's a couple or three of you around the area.
You came down to my house.
I did go to your house?
Yes.
What did I do at your house?
Well, you came for garage sale.
Remember that?
Yes.
Yes, and then I think you told me that you watched hometown TV, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Well, what is this here for? Now you're raising money for your club.
For the senior
club. Yeah.
Okay. What do you do with the money once you got it?
Well, we use it to go out for dinner or to take trips. Or
So it pays for part of the trip and you pay the balance?
Right.
How many people in your center?
About 50.
You do have that many. What area do you cover? All of the town of Chazy?
West Chazy, Plattsburgh, Moores. A lot of them from Moores.
So some people belong to more than one club.
Right. Right.
That way you could eat more and more and make more trips, huh?
Yeah.
Are these people helping you over here? Are they some of the cooks?
That's one of my seniors.
That's one of your seniors,
huh?
Is she your senior or just a senior?
She's a senior.
She's a, not your
she's
senior.
She's mine too.
Oh, she's your senior
yeah.
too. All right. Well, tell you, this is all home baked in the West Chazy
right.
area, huh?
That's right.
Just members that bake this?
Just the members.
Just the
right.
members. You bake it at home. You don't bake it at the meetings.
No.
You eat at the meetings.
That's right.
All right.
When we have a covered dish, we eat.
How often do you have to get together to eat? Every week?
We meet every week, but we have a covered dish once a month.
Okay.
And then every now and then we go out for dinner.
Okay.
To get a change.
It sounds like all you do in this club is eat and go on trips.
We play bingo.
Oh, do you play bingo?
Penny bingo, yeah.
Do you ever win?
Once in a while.
Come down and see our bingo in St. Mary's in Champlain, too.
I do.
Do you do?
Let me win.
Well, you've got to come on that first Monday of the month. We're getting double bingos now.
I was there Monday night.
This past Monday?
Yeah.
I didn't see you.
Well,
you must have seen me. I was up there making mistakes, if you remember.
Was it you that made all those mistakes?
Oh, I helped. I helped, though, a little bit.
Yeah.
This lady's going to say, I'm not going to talk to you, are you? Yes, you are. Just going to say
my
hello?
Daughter. I'm not a senior citizen yet.
You're not, are you down here taking lessons so you'll know what to do when you're... And she said that you're her daughter, so
yeah,
she's your
I brought
mom.
My mom.
Well, you better tell me your name first.
Jan Riel from West Chazy.
All right, and your mother can speak for herself, or should
That's
I ask
right.
you about her?
I know, she
She'll
can speak.
Speak for herself,
yeah.
All right, mm-hmm. we'll talk to her in a minute. So you're down here just helping out?
I'm here visiting.
Visiting?
Yes.
And you came this far to visit your mother?
No, I took my mother
You took
here.
Your mother here, all right?
Yes.
And you haven't left yet?
And not yet, we're going to eat.
You're going to go eat right now?
That's
all right.
right.
We're going to have chicken.
Is that it?
I understand. If you eat whether all the others eat, I guess you've got other things here too.
Uh-huh.
All right. Well,
a lot of goodies.
You come back here and get their dessert.
Yes.
Okay. Oh, that's right. You get your dessert here and you eat it here or bring it home. So tell me, are you, I forgot what I was going to ask you. You're not old enough to me to be talking to you even.
No, that's true.
Pretty soon.
This part don't count, but we got a chance to meet her anyway.
That's right.
Thank you for talking to us. All right. Now, the real purpose we're here. This lady was here before this lady on my right. Your name, ma'am?
I own Barcombe.
All right. Yeah. And you're from West Chazy?
Yes.
Lived in Chazy most of your life?
Yes.
All right.
Yes.
How long have you been a member of the Senior Citizens Club?
Oh, my husband started it.
Oh, he started it?
Yeah.
Well, he must have started with your help, too.
Yes.
You betcha, yeah.
Yeah.
But you look forward to the meetings?
Oh, yes.
Huh?
Yes.
You know, it's surprising. Like he mentioned up there, you know, when you're talking 30% or more of the people are over 60 years of age, there is a big buy-in power and a big control in this county. All you got to do is get together and you can control this county. There's no bigger groups around, you know. And I'm one of them, too, by the way. I'm in that group now, yeah.
Oh,
I'm in that
sure.
group, yeah, but I... All right, so... What is your specialty in baking? What do you bake specially? Bake bread?
Oh,
she's a good cook. She used to be cook at the store. Maybe I used to
Oh, did you? How long were you there?
I was head cook about 15 years.
When you were there 15 years cooking, did your husband have to go home and cook for himself, or did you get home in time to make his meal?
We got home in time.
You always had time, huh?
Oh, yeah.
How big a family did you have?
I had 8 children.
Oh, that's where you learned how to cook. Huh?
Yes. Good cook.
Good cook. All right. Well, you're a good talker. I'm glad they and a smile. You're smiling a lot.
I only hope my husband was here. He's in the hospital.
Oh, is he? Oh, that's too bad. He can't.
He strokes. So.
Oh. I hope he's better real quick.
Yeah.
In the meantime, thank you for talking to us, both of us. And I'm not going to wish you that you get to be a senior citizen pretty quickly, but it comes quicker than you think.
That's right. Not before my time.
All right. West Chazy Senior Citizens Club. Now, we don't usually go out. It's not my favorite subject, you know, is funeral directors, but there's three here today. There's three here being represented because they've got questions people are asking. One of the reasons we're stopping here is because this name R.W. Walker is very, very well known in the Moores Forks area. And this is where you're, John J. Walker.
Right,
hi, John. Why would we know Walker's name in Moores Forks?
Well, my father, who was Robert Walker, was from Moores Forks and started his business in Shazy, and so he's well acquainted with the northern area, and most of my family's from along the border. So.
Did he ever work for Ralph Lewis when Ralph had a place way back?
No, I don't think he ever worked for Ralph Lewis. But
then he started a new one in Shazy?
In Shazy. He started on his own.
Where was he at Shazy? Do you remember? Did he ever tell
you? He was right up near the tracks, little road that went off to the side.
All right, yes. Yep,
and he was one of those houses up on that little road before you get the tracks.
Then did he buy one in Plattsburgh that was established?
No, he didn't buy one. He started alone in Plattsburgh.
That's tough to do.
It certainly
because is. Because a lot of people go for funerals where their parents were, their uncles and friends, generally, you know. The last thing you think of is advertising when someone dies.
Right.
You think of where was I last, you know, with my family and so forth.
Yep.
And how long have you been with the business?
21 years.
Active. You've been with it all your life, dude.
Right.
You had to be down there.
Yeah, I was, you know, doing cleaning and stuff when I was young, driving flowers and so forth. But I've been a licensed funeral director for 21 years.
And there's two brothers?
My brother Richard and I.
Okay.
And we have several employees that are licensed.
Okay.
Matter of fact, Glenn Robbins, who is retiring next year, is also from
the Moores area. Yes, yes. He went to school at Moores Central.
Right.
Well, what can a funeral home do at a function like this?
Well, I think our greatest mission is to let people know about pre-arranging funerals. At the time of death, to try and arrange a funeral can take as long as two and a half hours. And at that time, it's the last thing you want to be doing is sitting and answering questions and making decisions. If people can come ahead of time, or their families can, and start to make some of these decisions and get it down on paper, and you're not locked into those decisions, but at least you thought about it.
Do you pay when you make these decisions?
That's a possibility also.
You may not have to, though.
You can do
both ways. Pay part, pay none, pay
right.
all.
Whatever you would like to do, but our funeral home will guarantee any prepaid funerals that are paid in total. And we rely on the interest on that money to make up for the rise in the cost of living.
But, John, you've been in it long enough to know that the last place I want to go is to make my arrangements. Generally, for where I'm going to go when I'm
right.
not here. I'm not trying to, for some reason, I think I'm going to advance the day if I go do that. I think that's what people think.
Well, we'll help you out in that area. We'll come to your house instead.
Okay. All right. You know, what you just mentioned, when I lost my mother and I went down, the last thing I wanted to do was talk to anybody.
Right.
And they asked me to make decisions, and I didn't give a darn what
that's
the decision
right.
was. Anything. Just get me out of here.
Yeah.
You know, and it's a bad time.
And what happens in that situation is we have people coming back afterwards and saying, gee, I wish I'd done this rather than the decision
yes.
I made
yeah.
that day, and they regret. Because those are the things you remember afterwards.
You still got relatives up in that area?
Sure do.
Dave, a couple. They watch Hometown Cable.
My cousin Bob and my uncle Clarence, but he's gone into the hospital this week.
Right,
and
Walker's up in Moores Forks. All right. It's always nice to see the people make good, too.
Yeah. And all my mother's family is from the other side of the border, from Hemingsburg, Normstown, and in that area. The Grays and Osmonds.
Okay, that's what we're talking about. See, they don't go very far. They don't go very far from the tree. Came as far as Plattsburgh.
Yeah, don't want to go any further. I might even like to go back someday.
Well, there you go. You go visit.
Oh, yes.
Thank you very much. John J. Walker. What's the J for? John.
James.
James. John James.
Well, thank you for stopping by.
You're welcome, John.
It's good to see somebody from the old homestead.
Well, thank you. We're at Al's Travel Club, Sunshine Vacation Club, and as I can remember now from memory, my mother, the way she used to say it, I think it was Mazzella?
Mazzula.
Well, I was close. I missed one letter. I was telling you how she said it, see?
Oh, yes, that's right.
My mother, Mrs. Castine, made several trips with this, with their, I don't know if it was at the Sunshine Clubs or not.
In 1974, when we first started trips, your mother was one of the first
Is
travelers.
That right?
Yes.
She used to love them. She couldn't get around as well as she'd have made more of them, you know?
Yes.
But she said that she used to always, she thought, I want to go with Al. You had some great people, she thought.
She
you had nice organization.
She was a loyal traveler and fun to be around.
Okay. Now, do you make those trips with them?
Always do.
You do. Well, tell us a little bit. Let's take a short break while that noise is behind us. Of course, the noise I was talking about, Al, was not really noise. Someone speaking. But I guess we can get over here on our mic. Tell
sure.
us a little bit about Al's Travel Service. What do you do? What is
well,
you?
We book airline tickets and train tickets in travel in general.
Right.
But we also specialize in group tours. Here we have a list of the trips that we put it out in advance for the entire year.
Like the you can see there's anywhere from 8 to 10 trips that you can go.
Yeah.
And does this have to be senior citizens, or do you have special ones for seniors?
The senior gets special treatment.
Okay. And how many do you get for a trip? Does it have to be a group, or do they just sign up individually?
They sign up individually, although the charter bus holds about 40 people.
Uh-huh.
So generally speaking.
So you're celebrating your 20th this year?
Yes.
Have you been in that? Were you in that before 1974 at all with somebody else?
No, I was in the insurance business.
Insurance business, that's a change, huh? A real switcheroo?
Yes.
Now, do you have specials, or do you have special, the Sunshine Vacation Club, is that a special one for the people that are over 60?
We specialize in senior citizens, yes.
Okay. Now, what's the most popular trip that you make? Would you say, if there is one? They used to like the Florida trip.
Florida trip was always popular.
Yeah, I know you go to the Western Music in Nashville.
Right, Montreal, the Atlantic City Casino trip is popular also.
Uh-huh.
Wildwood, New Jersey.
When they go to New Jersey to Atlantic City, I hope you get all your money before they go, because you're in trouble if they lose it all down there.
And we have blank checks.
You have your, and you go down there with them and all the rest of the trip?
I go down there with them and lose my money also.
It sounds to me like it's more of a vacation for you than it is a job.
Well, that's a vacation, although I do like to look after people's needs.
Uh-huh.
And,
okay, if you'd like to see, a lot of our people from up north, the Bay Shores and others that I've talked with that make these trips, and if you want to know and travel somewhere where you don't want to make your own decisions, they can make the decisions for you, and then they have side trips they can take on their own.
Exactly.
They don't have to go to everything. And one of the places, at least, is Al's Travels here in Plattsburgh. There may be others, and we're not here to advertise Al's Travels. We're letting you know what's available from him or others. I know he has them because that's the one my mother and some of our friends up north have gone to, and they've all been very, very happy with the service and with the trips.
Nice.
And with Al, too, even if they can't pronounce his name, Missoula.
Right.